Hi, everyone. I was so excited to speak with Claudia Oshry yesterday. Claudia, I'm wearing my Ben glasses, hoping it gets your attention. Firstly, I have to thank you so much for sharing your dream with me. Dreams are a very personal reflection of what's going on in our waking life, and I feel blessed and thankful that you shared yours with me. This is the analysis of how and why your dreams reveal your very intelligent choice of metaphor in order to accomplish its healthy goal. One, I want to talk to you about how the images appear in the dream. Okay, let's start with how do the images that we use in the dreams, where do they come from? And so I want to absolutely agree with you that you chose the Holocaust because you happened to be watching a Netflix show about the Holocaust as you were falling asleep. And that's true, I agree with you, except for one thing. The images that we choose while we're having a discussion with ourselves, which is the dream, the images that we choose are not random. So, for example, if you're watching the news and you see something about a war before you go to sleep, then you will only use those images if you so happen to be at war with yourself about something, or maybe you're pissed off at somebody that you do business with or someone in the family. The point is, it's not random. We are so sophisticated that it's not random, the choices that we make. And I want to add that your choice of the Holocaust, brilliant, brilliant, creative, and it just shows in the background the intelligent person and humor that people like me see on the outside. Secondly, I want to add that because our associations to people and images are so unique, I'm projecting from my own experience that your choice of Holocaust is brilliant because you are in effect rehearsing what no control feels like. And at the same time, we can even rehearse panic. So when the actual event comes to pass, you know that expression, been there, done that? That's what you are doing. That's why the dream is so brilliant and I have so much respect for it. You are practicing panic. You're practicing what having no control feels like. And it's the same thing as exercising muscles in a gym. You're building yourself up, preparing yourself. And actually what happens is you desensitize yourself because as the virus moves in closer to us, you are more and more ready for it because panic is like been there, done that. I've been doing that in my dreams for the last 2 weeks or something. So you actually are more ready to handle what's happening around you. And this is why I just can't tell you how much I respect and appreciate that you shared your dream with me. And the last thing I want to say, which is very important to me, is I was so completely excited and freaked out that I was having an opportunity to speak with you one-on-one that I completely forgot to tell you that you can find me at haveagreatdream.com. That's it. Haveagreatdream.com. Thank you, Claudia.